If you thought the point of school was to prepare you for the real world, then I'm afraid you are wrong. Because that was never the intention of the school system to begin with. The intention of the school system was to make you a better learner. The intention of the school system was to make you more adaptive to different environments and different scenarios and to help you learn at a better rate. And this means that when an employer has to choose between someone who has good grades on a CV or someone who has bad grades on a CV, they're more likely to choose the person who has good grades because they know they're better at learning different things at a better rate, even if the fact that the stuff that they learned in school may not at all be useful to the stuff that they may be exposed to in the working environment. And that is the process of schooling. This type of thing where you sit down in a class, you listen to the teacher, you take notes, maybe even it's about stuff that you don't actually care about, and then you take exams where you may forget all the subject content immediately after you've taken the exam. But many people confuse this process of schooling with education, despite the fact that the two could be no farther from each other. Schooling and education are two things that are incredibly different, yet people assume they are exactly the same thing. Many people assume that education ends once school ends, once they graduate, once they drop out of high school. They assume that education ends once they leave the school system forever. But that could not be farther from the truth. 50% of people never pick up a book again once they leave school. Once they leave like high school, once they graduate, once they leave college or university, or whatever kind of stage people are leaving the school system at, 50% of people never ever pick up a book again in their life. And that's because they assumed that their education ended when the process of schooling also ended. But the fact is, your education really mostly begins when schooling ends. But even if you are still in school, you should never let schooling get in the way of your education. School cannot cater for everything. There are so many different topics and so many different subject matters in the world, and if you were interested in any of these but school may not teach them to you, that does not mean that it's useless. It just means you must educate yourself on these topics. You may be interested in earning financial freedom, or you may be interested in your health, and if school isn't going to provide you with the necessary information for these topics, then you must read about them, you must learn about them. You can watch podcasts, YouTube videos, and while I still recommend doing things such as reading, these things are all valuable sources of information. So I really encourage you to actually start to learn things that like you're interested in, even if school doesn't cater for them and still only teaches the kind of basics like science, maths, and English. And science, maths, and English, these things only require a certain type of thinking. Specifically, science and maths only really require like logical thinking, and this doesn't really enhance certain parts of your brain. It only really focuses on the logical parts and the parts that mean that you can learn at a quicker rate. It doesn't focus on your introspective or intraspective parts of your kind of neurological system. And introspective means that you are able to kind of analyze and think deeply about certain things about yourself. And introspective means that you have good social skills. And if you currently like struggle with these things, you struggle with social skills, or you struggle with analyzing your own thoughts, emotions, and beliefs, that is something that you must read about, because school never taught about these things. This is just one example of something that school kind of glossed over in the however many or so years we are in the school system. So you must read about these things. There are so many books out there on mindfulness and meditation and journaling, and all you have to do is just either find them on like an ebook or PDF, and you might even get them for free. But if you want, you can buy these books, and it's perfectly in your capability to do so. And yeah, as I say, just because you didn't learn these things in school, that does not mean they're useless. Many things in school are not really useful in the real world, but the fact is they're just useful as a marker to say how well you can actually learn something and how this can be applied, how the way that you are able to learn and the quickness of the how you were able to learn can be applied to another different working situation. And you may quite think about this, but school never taught you about self-improvement. School never taught you about the process of continuous learning, continuous education, and continuous improvement, and trying to become your better self. And that might seem to be like a conspiracy. That may seem to be something that like people would like against the Matrix and all that kind of stuff would say. But what if it could be true? School never taught us about how to be a happier person. Sorry about that, that was just a low battery. School never taught us how to be happy. School never taught us how to do things like gratitude journal and meditate. And therefore, these are things that you need to read about and learn about. Because success does not come, or happiness more rather, does not come from being successful in life. Happiness must be the thing that you first focus on, and then success will follow once you kind of start to become grateful and have good mental health and be a happier person. But school may not want you to kind of understand that process, because obviously the whole kind of matrix and stuff says that obviously they want you to be a worker and not really to provide anything in the form of entrepreneurship. And school also never taught you about things like dieting. Now, dieting is not something that people do for 2 weeks when they want to lose a bit of weight. Dieting is something that people do when it's through every meal that they ever eat throughout their entire lives. Every meal that you eat has an impact on your body, even if it may be the slimmest, most minuscule thing you could possibly imagine. And therefore, your diet and stuff is something that should be stringently watched by you and by your brain. But school never taught us this, and school really never decided to look at the kind of foods that actually harm our body. And while you may understand this kind of stuff if you're sort of in universities, if you're studying really advanced sciences and stuff like that, really advanced like food, like development, you may understand like what foods actually kind of hurt our bodies. But in the common GCSEs and A-levels, where it really only develops our logical like side of our brains, and it doesn't really specify into things that are actually going to help us get a job and actually are going to be things that we sort of use on those jobs. This, like things like GCSEs and A-levels, they're not really things that you actually would use on jobs, and they're just a benchmarker to see how well you can learn and how well you can learn and therefore how much employers can trust you to learn on the job in a way. And school never taught us to actually self-learn. School never taught us to educate ourselves on different matters. I mean, I've been talking about educating yourselves on so many different things about this video, whether it be your health, your happiness, any other kind of thing you're interested in, whether it be sports or finance and money. School never taught us to teach ourselves how to educate ourselves on other subject matters that we may be interested in. We've always had an authority figure in the form of teachers telling us how to do this and how to do that, setting us homework, setting us tasks and deadlines, and we've never been taught how to do this ourselves. And this means that when it comes to actually people trying to build something out of themselves and getting onto self-improvement, they don't really know how to educate themselves, because it's not something that they've ever learned in the school system. And educating yourself on how to effectively educate yourself is quite a tough process, but it's not really something there are many how-to guides on, and it's really just something you kind of have to figure out on the kind of journey of self-improvement. So, in conclusion, school will not ever provide anything that you actually want in life. There are going to be so many things that school won't teach about, whether it be like sports, whether it be really specific sports that you were never done in like PE in school, whether it be entrepreneurship and all that stuff that school doesn't really teach you about. All of this stuff, you have to educate yourself on it, because school cannot talk about every single subject matter and every single thing that kind of goes on in this world. And if you're interested in it, you must educate yourself on it. And while I am interested in some things in school, such as like science and maths and stuff, I know that many people out there could not care less about that stuff. And I just want to provide you with the knowledge that maybe it is okay to actually educate yourself and self-learn about other things that aren't like taught in school. Because just because it isn't taught in school, that does not mean it won't be useful to you, useful to your knowledge, and useful to your ability to either get a job or build a business in life. So I hope you found value about this video. And I also recommend subscribing, because I like this community of young tribal people who are willing to improve themselves so much more than they already have. And good luck.